What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Vogelstad, the City Skylines series that suddenly looks a lot better than usual. That is, of course, because I am now no longer playing on a MacBook Pro. I put the specs in the description below. You can get a look at that if you care. So getting started, a little bit of housekeeping. This church, the only big Dutch church on the workshop, is way too bright. So I'm using this technique that I learned from Da Wicked, who makes the Denord series, where you put a black box over it in PO and turn down the opacity of it to darken assets a little bit. And now I'm laying out a little bit of the area I'm going to be working in, which is in the all the way up at the top, at the very edge of what would be considered the old town. This is going to be the Jewish quarter, the historic Jewish quarter. I think in modern times, we're not really seeing as big of a Jewish population here anymore. Maybe a little bit. I think, you know, if it's anything like New York, you know, the older Jewish populations, like, they tend to go to the fringes. Either, you know, the older communities either become very Orthodox or they become very secular. And I would imagine that if this stayed anything, it probably would have stayed very Orthodox. So maybe that's what it is. Maybe this neighborhood is pretty Orthodox. But historically, this would have been the place where all the Jews of Vogelstad would have lived, because back in the days, they, you know, people would, like, the governments of cities and municipalities and whatever would force you to live in the Jewish quarter if you were Jewish. They would, you know, that's why a lot of times you see these sort of, like almost self-contained communities in Jewish quarters. You know, you'll see, like, businesses that don't exist elsewhere, or I should say, like, businesses that are redundant to other places because, you know, the Jews had to fend for themselves. They had to create their own whole, you know, confined ecosystem. So let's talk a little bit about what I'm doing on screen. What I'm doing right now is I've been playing with these Citadel assets that are kind of just, like, nice, boxy, like, fairly generic European looking. They can kind of fit in a lot of different places. And here I'm making it into a, I think what I'm thinking of it as is a museum of Jewish art, I think would be what it is now. I think historically maybe it was like a Hebrew school or something of that like. But I'm kind of messing around with PO right now, trying to make sort of like a janky looking cement Star of David that, you know, when you see it, it looks a little funny, but I feel like it's very reminiscent of a certain genre of Jewish art that, if you have Jewish grandparents, you've seen a lot of. Like, I feel like this janky Star of David looks very much like something that would have been in my grandmother's living room on, like, a tchotchke shelf. Is tchotchke a Jewish term? I wonder if other people say that. Write in if you call little knickknacks tchotchkes. I'm curious now. But yeah, so just kind of spending a little bit of time detailing this kind of separate of the rest of the city. I like having these, like, little pockets, little tiny spots that are more detailed than other spots. It's kind of a nice way to handle this sort of project. And then I put this big modern one behind it as almost like an auxiliary building, like an annex, like maybe at some point there was a bigger building here, like a you know, like a bank or something like that, and then the museum kind of bought it and tore it down and turned it into an extension of the museum. So I was thinking that this is sort of a modern wing of it that you know, you can enter from this main road instead of having to go all the way through all the twisty alleys and stuff of this neighborhood. But yeah, so this neighborhood is very oh, we're already up to this. Okay, never mind. We'll talk about that later. What we're talking about now is the Gerard Doustraat Synagogue, which is an asset that I made. I've never made one before. This is the first one that I'm ever publishing on the workshop. If you're hearing this, if this is published, this episode, then that means that the synagogue is published as well, so you can take a look at the workshop link in the description below. But essentially, I was very frustrated with the quantity and diversity of synagogues that are on the workshop. There's really only like three or four, and most of them are pretty old. The best one, I think, is the Broom Street one that Feinbold made ages ago. It's really old now. And it still looks really great, but it really very distinctly looks like New York to me. And I wanted something that was a little more decorative and a little more cool. So I made my own. I learned how to use Blender and just made it. So, I mean, let that be a lesson, I guess, really, is I was really inspired by City Walk, City Wall on this, that, like, you can just learn to do this stuff. It seems like that's what all the asset creators did. So why not, you know, just learn how to make the stuff you want. It didn't take a terribly long time. I think maybe the synagogue was like the culmination of a few weeks of work, maybe. It took me about a month to figure out Blender well enough to actually make it, and then maybe it was like a few days of modeling and then a few days of texturing and then, you know, spread out over a few weeks. So here I'm making a little backyard for it. And my thinking was that historically, maybe this was a the synagogue had been sort of a industrial building, and that had been kind of run down back in the day. And the Jews of the neighborhood kind of banded together and bought the land to build a synagogue on for them, because they'd previously probably been operating out of a house or something like that, out of somebody's home, most likely the rabbi. So they kind of banded together and bought this land and built a synagogue on it. And it was kind of bigger and had this like back entrance for loading goods. And so they would have possibly maybe left that open as like a nice little yard for having, you know, weddings and other community events in. And yeah, and maybe like a little secret back entrance for getting in and out. This was an interesting episode for me because, you know, obviously growing up here in America and in New York and Long Island and whatever, like, you get really disconnected from a lot of this sort of stuff. You know, like, I feel like I know so much about my Jewish heritage, but I'm not really that connected to it. And kind of researching for stuff for this video, it ended up being a much more emotional experience than I had anticipated. And there's something coming a lot later that you'll kind of understand a little bit more, but I kind of put off this last build until the end. I guess I'll just say it. It's a Holocaust memorial. I made a Holocaust memorial for the neighborhood. And I don't think I've ever seen anybody do that in City Skylines. I feel like we have a tendency to think of our cities as like fantasy builds. And in your fantasy, presumably the Holocaust didn't happen in your fantasy. But I wanted to add a level of realism to this, to kind of, you know, place this city in the real world in some sense. So yeah, I mean, that's coming later. I kind of put it off until the end because it just, as I was starting to research Holocaust memorials around the world, like, they kind of, I think when I think of them, I've always thought of them as being sort of like usually pretty on the nose, a little bit like tacky art at times. But then when you start looking at them, the more and more you see them, the more of these like common themes you start seeing, and it just started getting me really emotional. And so I just stopped working on it and put it off until the very end, so that I could like mess around with this, what you're seeing on screen right now, this sort of modern building that's kind of just like plopped into the middle of this neighborhood. You can kind of see that I'm breaking the grid a lot in this neighborhood, and I will be in the next episode too. We're kind of in the middle of like the very, very old town, you know, or I guess like these are kind of older parts of the city, right, that we're working on these first bunch of episodes. And once we get out of the old town, like, the level of planning is going to be much, much higher. And, you know, the neighborhoods are going to be very strict and extremely, you know, Dutch suburban. So I don't want to get too gritty. I want to mess with the shapes of roads as much as I can here, because I'm not going to be able to later when I'm in the more planned neighborhoods. So this is sort of my thinking, is that this probably was maybe it was a square, maybe this was a lot of houses and there was a big fire, but for some reason or another, there was this kind of like big open but strangely shaped spot. And this building would have been put there during that time. I think the university is going to be on the other side of the canal from the synagogue. And if you can't tell where we are right now, we're maybe like we were like maybe a block or two north of the synagogue. So I think that that is going to be student housing. So maybe the university kind of like bought that land and built a big piece of, a big student housing building there. So now we're on this sort of main road that leads from the main square up to here in the Jewish quarter, and it's going to lead all the way to the furthest north points of the city that are, you know, accessible by public transit. So I'm trying to kind of like build up the density along this street a bit, kind of put all the offices and commercial buildings along this street so that people can reach it, you know, by transit. Because that's kind of what you want, you know. This is so because we're kind of further out from the oldest core of the city. This is kind of where space kind of stops being at such a premium that everything is crammed together. So I started putting a couple of backyards. I'm not really a huge backyard guy, so you'll see the style of detailing I'm doing is fairly minimal. Just throwing some flowers, throwing some trees, a couple of tables, a couple of playgrounds. That's really it. You know, just give it like, I like to put like big trees in the backyards so that, you know, you just get little peeks through of what's back there. So now we're working on this huge building that I think is the same person who makes all those really cool Dansk buildings. All like the Renaissance and Gothic and whatever buildings that I'm trying to find homes for in this city. But basically, I was trying to make it a corner building. And I left in the take of me trying to do it and failing. And I got frustrated and just kind of brought it all the way over here to just like destroy everything but the face. And my thinking is that this was probably some sort of like historically significant building for the neighborhood. You know, maybe like a bank or something like that. You know. It's a pretty hilly neighborhood. They're all going to be hilly neighborhoods. I really should have done more prep on this map to make it fully flat before I started this, but I think I'm just starting to embrace it and just starting to enjoy what it looks like building on hills. I know it's not maybe the most realistic thing in the world, but it is what it is, you know? So maybe this is going to become Vogelstad, the City Skylines series that gets less realistic every episode. So this is going to be right here. You're seeing me starting to define the edge of the city. What we're doing here is kind of this would have been a second expansion. You'll see when we do an overhead view that there is sort of this like inner ring of canals, and then this is going to be part of a large outer ring. And my thinking was that the oldest parts of the old town are all in the center, kind of by the square and by the train station and whatever. And at some point, you know, the population of the city got too big, so they started building this secondary ring, and that's what's out here. And I'm kind of just defining the edge of it. You see, I kind of put like a, I put kind of a kink in the road, and I was thinking that that was probably historically part of the city defenses. That would have been one of those big, really characteristic star arms, I guess you call them, like the spiky part of a star. That would have been one of those, and I think those were like old. Those would have been like the vantage points from which you like fire cannons and stuff at invaders. I don't know much about city defense. I just know what it kind of looks like. So I just put it like that. But yeah, just building out this neighborhood a bit. I mean, there's much more neighborhood development in this episode, and sadly the next one, than I really like to do. I want to do more bigger projects. But I guess how many of those can there really be? This is kind of just a series of a few different bigger projects, or, you know, medium. I'd say medium-sized projects, right? Oh, I didn't talk about this, by the way. I made these little market parks, kind of based on Mr. Miyagi's sidewalk cafe assets. And I just kind of took all the street market stuff that I had and just made little configurations of it and saved them as parks. And I know somebody published recently a bunch of those as MoveIt export files. And that's cool. Those are very helpful, too. I've used those in the city already. But it's really nice to save them as parks, because if you do that, then people use them. And, like, sure, you know, the animation isn't there to, like, have them walking up and, like, looking at fruit or something like that, but it does attract people. So if you line a street with market parks like that, then you end up getting, like, a huge crowd of people who are walking and visiting all the stalls. And so you can create a more realistic scene of a farmer's market. And I was kind of thinking that I guess that's historically what this neighborhood would have been really known for. It's kind of a weird memory I have of Amsterdam, and I took a ferry tour, one of those canal tours, and the tour guide was showing us the old Jewish quarter. And he, in this very, like, as I've come to understand it, very typically Dutch, very blunt way, was talking about how the term flea market comes from the Jewish quarter, because there were these old markets there, and everybody thought that the Jews were dirty and had fleas, and so that's where the term came from. And I don't think that he meant it in any sort of anti-Semitic way, but rather, I think that he just, like, was stating the facts as he knew them, and it was just a very interestingly blunt way to put it. So here is kind of the last thing that we're really working on for this project. This is kind of, I made a park out of the edge of the city, and then this is the beginning of the Holocaust Memorial. I found this cool star thing that Ronix made, and it kind of looks like a Star of David that has, like, a few different dimensions to it. Like, if you look at it from different angles, it's a Star of David each way. And then this is, I used PO on one of the, you know, one of the included blocks, and I used the wall from a Holocaust memorial in Utrecht, I think. Maybe it's in Leiden, I don't remember. Anyway, we're getting to the end here. Thank you guys so much for watching my show. I hope you liked it. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment. It really helps people find the show. Follow me on Twitter at Jeremy Thunder. Check out my podcasts, Ballin' Out Super and Generation Loss. And I will see you next time.